Hi, I'm Joseph Kern, instructional designer at Emporia State University. In your classes, your instructors may ask you to make a graphic organizer or a concept map. Lots of times they'll give you a template or an idea and you have to recreate it. So it could be something like this, where it's just a simple bunch of rectangles or a table. But if you're making something more complicated, like one of these, or this, then it can be a lot more difficult to try and design it on your own by drawing your own rectangles and drawing your own lines and moving them around. So instead, you can build them in Microsoft Word using SmartArt. So the first way you can build these is just to go to Insert and SmartArt. And let's say I'm going to build this one. It's pretty complicated. Actually, this one is probably three different SmartArt drawings. It's three organizers in one. So you have one thing that branches into two, you have two things that go back and forth, and you have one thing that goes to this one to the right of it. So when you go to SmartArt, you can pick which thing you want. They break them down a little bit into different little sets. There's some crossover between those, but I think we're looking for a hierarchy for that top one, so it's one thing that branches down into two. They don't have a picture of one thing branching into two, they have this really complicated one. So how do we make that one thing that branches down into two? All we have to do is pick, let's see, looks like those two things, well let's get rid of that. So we can just click on that and hit delete. Now we have one thing that branches into three, so let's get rid of that one. Now one thing branches into two. In this case then, we can just type right onto each of these. To fill in that content. In addition to being able to type into these, off to the left here, in this is Word 2016, you have a little arrow. In other versions of Word, you may have a thing up here, a little icon that looks like a menu maybe, and if you click on it, you get this box that pops out. And so you can see the things we typed in here originally ended up being put into this list. If I decide I want three subtitles, we'll call that subtitles. All I have to do is hit enter and just start typing in. If I decide that this third one needs a subtitle, it's just like making any regular bulleted list in Word. I just hit enter and I hit tab to indent it a little bit there. And I have a subtitle. I could do that with any of them. And just the same, I can edit the list by getting rid of those if I want to get rid of them and make it look the way we want. All right, next up we had two boxes that go back and forth a little bit. Let's shrink this guy down to give us some room. Now when they went working with Word, it is a little bit tougher to be able to move things around, so I'm gonna put that in front of text and I'll be able to move it wherever I want. So insert SmartArt, looking for one thing going into two. I think that would be a relationship. And they don't have anything perfect there, but we'll go with this. And let's do that behind text also, so that way it goes right there. Alright, so this one, same thing, I can have title 1, click in there, title 2, that looks, in this case, like I have just two bullets. If I want a subtitle on this, this isn't set up to be branching like this original one was. This one just is a text box, so anything I do, subtitle is just listed as bullets underneath that first one. Now, one thing you may want to do sometimes, they don't let you edit these as much as you want, so for whatever reason, you don't want this arrow here, if you want to get rid of it. You can't just click on it and delete it, because it's one of those preset things, but you can get around that. If there's anything that they've given you that you want to get rid of, You can go to Format, and this is also true for just changing the settings on them. So if I want to change color, I can make it orange. In this case, if I want to get rid of it, I can give it no fill and no outline, and it still exists, but you just can't see it anymore. So that's a way to get rid of anything that they give you that you don't want. Now, that's one way to approach it, is build this structure first and then put in content. But lots of times when you're working with these, it may be easier to start with the content. So if I have a structure like this, I want to put these in to show the relationship of from kingdom down to species. So what I can do is I'm going to copy that bullet. I'm going to insert SmartArt, pick the one that I want. In this case, let's see. We have a relationship, we're going to go with that one. And so, rather than typing each of those into here, because I already typed up that list earlier, I'm just going to get rid of all of this text. I'm going to hit paste, so Control V to paste those in there. And they're there, automatically, without me having to do any other typing. So if you already have that list there, it makes it really easy. If we have something more complicated, again, we can do SmartArt. This will be a hierarchy. Just picking one there. Ooh, we can put in pictures. So I'm going to copy that list. I'm going to click on the art. I'm going to get rid of all that. I'm going to paste, and it automatically puts a picture beside each one if I want it. Now you can do extra things to these. You can insert a shape if you want to draw an arrow from, let's see, something like that. So you can always add in your own shapes on top of those to customize whatever you need. But when you're looking for the quick way to make your graphic organizer, a couple approaches, but the big thing is use this tool on the side when it gets really complicated and you're trying to set things up in a way that's a lot easier for you than having to drag things all over the place. Okay. The other nice thing compared to the build it on your own is if you do move something around, it still tries to link them automatically. So you're not having to redraw every single line and arrow that you originally started with. So hope this helps. Have a good time graphic organizing.